In the second stanza of Sailing to Byzantium, Yeats presents a pathetic picture of old age. Age is unnecessary. That's the first line. An aged man is but a paltry thing. An aged man or old man is a paltry, means worthless thing. A tattered coat upon a stick. This is the image of a scarecrow in a fertile field. So, the poet compares old age to a scarecrow, means the cast off remnant of life. It's a discarded cloth. That's what is human life in old age. The line, in fact, represent his fury against age. Unless soul clasps its hands and sings and louder sing. There is a repetition of sir sound in this line, which lends it with a lyrical grace and delicate suggestiveness. It suggests there is an option for the old man. He must sing the praises of the God. He must redeem his self by singing the praises of the God. That is the only alternative for the old age. Soul clasps his hands and sings and louder sing. For every tatter in his mortal dress. There are two powerful images in this line. One is a tatter. Tatter is the image of sin. Yeats, being a metaphysical writer who believes in the dichotomy of self and soul. Self is dying, but soul is an immortal element. So he has come to this holy city for the training of his soul. And these two lines describe his purpose. Nor is there a singing school, but a studying. Monuments of its own magnificence. Byzantium is a place where the churches of East and West, they meet. It is the holy place for Christianity. So he has come to this city to train his soul, to find a spiritual consciousness, a spiritual way of life. And therefore I have sailed the seas and come to the holy city of Byzantium. He has come to this city for spiritual redemption, for salvation, for nirvana. So the second stanza, after having given a picture of old age, suggests a way out for the old man. If you want to keep your individual self intact, you must find a spiritual way, a way of life, to transcendence, to spirituality, to redemption. In the third stanza of 8 lines, he is in the city of Byzantium, which is painted with the mosaic, the golden mosaic, and there are some sages or saints standing in the holy fire, the God's holy fire. He calls upon them. So this opening line is an invocation to sages. O sages standing in God's holy fire. Fire is the symbol of lust in the natural world. But fire becomes a holy fire in the spiritual world. So he calls upon sages whose unholy desires whose carnal desires have been purged off, they have been purified. So he calls upon them and asks them to be the master of his soul. As in the gold mosaic of wall, they are painted on the golden color. Gold is the symbol of transcendence, of purity, of soul. It's a Plato's image, a Plato's symbol is there for art and transcendence. Come from the holy fire, perine in a jaya. So come from the holy fire, perine in a jaya is a phrase taken from his prose work called A Vision. It's a very complex symbol. It simply means come circling round. So all the magical manifestation, all the spiritual beings, they come circling round. So perine in a jaya means come circling round and be the singing master of my soul. Teach my soul how to sing the praises of the God, how to redeem the self, consume my heart away sick with desire. The image of heart comes from Shelleyan influence on Yeats' poetry. So the poet believes heart is the seat of passion, both holy and unholy. Heart can be turned to the physical world for the fire of lust, but it can be turned to the spiritual life in the praises of the God, and there it becomes the seat of holy passion. Consume my heart away. So consume is a strong verb, and it shows Shelley's impact from Prometheus Bound. Prometheus was a legendary figure. He stole fire to help mankind, and for this act of stealth he was punished by God. He was tried to pose in open barn and open space, and vultures were set upon him. They will eat his heart every morning and it will renew every night. This is the symbolic suggestiveness of the image. So heart is the seat of desire, and he wishes his heart to be purified. It should be purged of all carnal desire, all sexual desire, and it should be turned to the service of God. Consume my heart away sick with desire. Sick is another strong word here, which means it's nauseated with, it's full of desire. So it should be purified for the service of God. And fastened to a dying animal, it remains confined to human self. The dying animal is a human cell and human body. So the poet believes in the dichotomy of soul and cell, and he reasserts here that soul is the immortal element, self is the mortal element. It knows not what it is. It knows not what its true worth. In other words, it can be turned to the service of God and gather me into the artifice of eternity, make me immortal, imperishable and lasting. This is the prayer, this is the wish of the speaker in the poem.